Hello everyone out there, my name is Torben Søndergaard and I am founder of the movement The Last Reformation. Maybe you have seen me on YouTube or in some of our movies, The Last Reformation The Beginning or The Last Reformation The Life. I need to do a video here that's very different from any other video that I have ever done. I'm going to do a video where I'm going to show clips from other videos from YouTube and warn against something that is happening right now. I've never done a video like this before, and the reason I began this video telling who I am and where I'm from is because I believe that this video is going to come out to people who have not heard about us before. And I want to say that this warning video is coming from people who are really living the life with God. We believe in discipleship. We believe in preaching the gospel, healing the sick, casting out demons. We are making disciples all over the world. We believe in doing the right things. This video is a warning, yes, but it's not coming from somebody who's just sitting on YouTube and putting videos together warning against everything. But now I see it is time to do a warning where I am going to even use clips like I've never done before. Because I see a train that is going very, very fast in the wrong direction. A unity train. A one world religion train. And I've seen many people I somehow respect, people who I know love Jesus, who are working in the kingdom, but they are all jumping on this train and it's going very, very fast. And I feel if I don't do this video now and come out with these warnings now, it will be too late for some in the future. Because when you are first on this train and it's going very, very fast, it's not easy to jump off. I know that this video is going to channel many people. It's going to provoke people. But I need to do this video. I need to tell you what is happening right now. I want to start with showing a clip from Kenneth Copeland's church in America. For you who don't know Kenneth Copeland, he is a tele-evangelist associated with the charismatic movement. And he's one of the main people when it comes to the prosperity gospel. He had a gathering short time ago for a lot of leaders. And there he invited the Catholic Bishop Tony Palmer. In this meeting, they talked about a meeting that was in 1999, where the Protestant Lutheran Church and the Catholic Church came together and made an agreement that we are all justified by faith alone without works, but to good works. And I want you to see what Tony Palmer is saying here on what we should call a Protestant platform with a lot of Protestant pastors and leaders. See this video here.
1999, the Roman Catholic Church and the Protestant Lutheran Church signed an agreement that brought an end to the protest. Luther believed that we were saved by grace through faith alone. Amen. But that's not it. The Catholic Church believed that we were saved by works. And that was the protest. So what these two churches did, they put the two definitions together. Listen to it. I'm reading verbatim from the Catholic Vatican website. Justification means that Christ himself is our righteousness, in which we share through the Holy Spirit in accord with the will of the Father. Together we, Catholics and Protestants, Lutherans, believe and confess that by grace alone, in faith in Christ's saving works, and not because of any merit on our part, we are accepted by God and receive the Holy Spirit, who renews our hearts while equipping and calling us to good works. This brought an end to the protest of Luther. Brothers and sisters, Luther's protest is over. Is yours. In 1999, this was signed by the Lutheran Church, the Federation Worldwide. Later, about 5 years later, the Worldwide Methodists signed the same agreement, but as of today, we still have had no Protestant evangelical that will stand up and sign this agreement to agree with our brothers and sisters that we are saved by grace through faith to good works. And I believe that's something that needs to be fixed. There's a challenge for you. So the protest has been over for 15 years. And I get a bit cheeky here because I challenge my Protestant pastor friends. If there is no more protest, how can there be a Protestant church? Maybe we're all Catholics again. But we are reformed. We're Catholic in the universal sense. We are not protesting the doctrine of salvation by the Catholic Church anymore. We now preach the same gospel. We now preach you are saved by grace through faith. Alone, the word alone was the argument for 500 years. The word alone is there. You can read it yourself. The protest is over. The protest is over.
This clip really shocked me because there's so many things in this clip that is so far off. I almost don't know where to start. I could start saying that it's correct that in 1999, the Protestant Lutheran Church and the Catholic Church came together and signed an agreement that said that we are saved by faith to good works and not saved by works. But Tommy Palmer here is saying that this is why we had the Reformation, because of that one thing. Already there, something is off. Yes, the Reformation was built on that. But Martin Luther came with more than one thesis. He came with 95 theses. And Martin Luther went against so many things inside the Catholic Church. If you're not aware of it, the Lutheran Church today don't have a pope. Martin Luther hated the pope. He was against the pope. And we should never have a pope. Then the whole idea that people today, including Protestant leader, called the Pope Holy Father, is so wrong. That is the title of God. And Jesus is very clear that we should not let anyone call anyone else Father, and especially not Holy Father. But today people have given the title of God to the Pope. But in the Catholic Church, they see the Pope as one who's in God's place. There's many things that Martin Luther went against that is not part of the Lutheran or the Protestant churches today. Like the whole Mary worship the Roman Catholic Church have. They believe that Mary is the mother of God. Not of Jesus, the man of God, but of God, born without sin. Holy. They believe that her body and soul was taken into heaven. And her prayer today have a unique role in redemption. Many Catholic people see Mary as more important than Jesus Christ. And then they have the whole belief in purgatory. Confession to a priest. Yeah, you have to be a priest. The whole thing with adultions. The rosary, the Hail Mary. There's so many things in the Catholic Church today that is so not biblical. And if Martin Luther was alive today, and if he saw what Tony Palmer was saying, he would have been shocked and he would have protested one more time. Because this is so far off. This is manipulated what you are seeing here. But instead of protesting against this, as Martin Luther will have done, we today have people like Kenneth Copeland, who call himself a Protestant Christian, I think he do, who believe in baptism with immersion, I think he do, who endorse something like this. I really don't understand this. What is happening right now? In another video, you can see that Kenneth Copeland is calling the Reformation the biggest demonic church split in the world. And when I hear that, I'm thinking, what is happening right now? What is happening here is that not only Kenneth Copeland, but we see that many pastors and leaders inside the prophetic and the charismatic movement are doing the same thing as Kenneth Copeland is doing right now. We see a unity with the Catholic Church that is going so fast, especially in America, where we see that many Protestant believers are inviting the Roman Catholic Church inside their churches. And we now have Catholic priests speaking on big conferences all over the world. Everyone out there, come to Denmark. Come to a country where we still have a state church. People in America have no idea what it is to grow up in a country with a state religion, with a state church. I live in Denmark and I got baptized as a baby, like 92% of all Danish babies did at that time. I got later confirmed without knowing God, without opening the Bible, without knowing the gospel. But I got baptized and I got confirmed and told that I was now born again. Everything was good. I was home. And in many years, I was thinking that if Christianity, if the Bible was correct, I was good. Why? Because I did what the priest told me to do. I did what the church told me to do. In my case, the Lutheran church, in many other cases, 1.2 billion people, the Catholic church. But the truth is that if you do what the Lutheran church, or if you do what the Roman Catholic Church tell you to do, you are deceived. You are lost. Because it's not built on the Word of God. It's not built on the Bible. And it don't bring salvation. Yes, Martin Luther did many good things for the church. But he did not reform the Catholic Church back to the Bible. We got a Lutheran church instead. Which still looks so much like the Catholic Church. We still have a state church religion that believe in baby baptism, that is deceiving millions of people all over the world because we are told a lie from birth on. But now we have Catholic priests representing the Catholic Church speaking on our meetings all over. Some will say, yeah, but they have the same spirit and they speak in tongues. If they have the same spirit, maybe some of them have, then I'm sure that the Holy Spirit will start teach them the truth. And the Holy Spirit will reveal the truth to them. And the Holy Spirit would make them draw away from that system. Like he's doing with many, many, many people here in Denmark in the Lutheran churches. Try to see this video that really shows what is happening right now. This is a video with a Catholic guy. And what he's saying here is really, really shocking to me. And I really don't understand why Protestant Christians who love Jesus put a man like this in their video. Because this video is not a video made by the Catholics. This is a video made by Protestant people. Try to see the video here.
What I cannot understand in my brothers that I love Pentecostals is that anytime I see in you something wrong, I will build another church. It's absurd. Certainly, even I am right, is a better, less perfect in unity and not the most perfect in disunity. The biggest sin is not if I am right or you are not right. The biggest sin is the disunity. So for what is right, I am making a bigger sin. This is so. The unity of the Catholic Church, even the institution, is a great testimony for my life, and I think for all the real Christians.
This guy, he's saying that the Catholic Church, even as an institution, is a great testimony for him. What? He's saying here, in a video made by Protestant believers, that it's better not to have the truth and have unity than to have the truth and have this unity. What I'm like, what is happening in the world today? What is happening in the church today? If people in history did what he was saying here in this video, we will all be deceived today and we will all be Roman Catholic today. After the Reformation with Luther, we saw the Anabaptists speaking clear about biblical baptism. Yes, many Anabaptists gave their life for the truth that baptism is after repentance on own faith with full immersion. And we believe in that today. Why? Because there were people in the past who did not go in for this false unity, but wanted to build on the truth and the truth alone. Much of what we believe today, when it comes to baptism, when it comes to faith, when it comes to repentance, when it comes to the priesthood of all believers, when it comes to the fivefold ministry, much of what we believe today, we believe because there was people in the past who wanted the truth rather than unity. Especially when it was a false unity that was not built on the Word of God. I want to say, Jesus did not come with peace. He came with strife. Where Jesus came, there was division. Light and darkness don't work together. His word divides. And we see that through church history. His word divide. But what I see that is really, really deceiving in all of this unity talk right now between the Catholic and the Protestant Church is that many Protestants really believe that we are talking about a unity between the Catholic and the Protestant Church, not knowing that at the same time there is another unity happening out there. A unity between the Catholic and Islam. A unity between the Catholic and Buddhism. A unity between the Catholic and everyone else. Yes, you are deceived if you believe that all of that is happening right now is just a unity between the Protestant and the Catholic Church. But what we are seeing right now is that it's really a unity between all religion. It's a one world religion that is happening right now in front of our eyes. And what we are seeing is just the beginning of that. And if you don't believe me, if you don't believe that this is not a unity just between the Catholic and the Protestant, with Kenneth Copeland and a few people and the Catholic Church, but it's really a unity between all religion that is really a talk about a one world religion. If you don't believe this, then see this video that Vatican have released.
La mayor parte de los habitantes del planeta se declaran creyentes. Esto debería provocar un diálogo entre las religiones. No debemos dejar de orar por él y colaborar con quienes piensan distinto.
Confío en Buda.
Creo en Dios.
Creo en Jesucristo.
Creo en Dios, Alá.
Muchos piensan distinto, sienten distinto, buscan a Dios o encuentran a Dios de diversa manera. En esta multitud, en este abanico de religiones, hay una sola certeza que tenemos para todos. Todos somos hijos de Dios.
Creo en el amor.
Creo en el amor.
Creo en el amor.
Creo en el amor.
Confío en vos para difundir mi petición de este mes. Que el diálogo sincero entre hombres y mujeres de diversas religiones conlleve frutos de paz y justicia. Confío en tu oración.
Everyone out there, come on. This video alone should be enough that every Protestant believer, everyone who loves God, who loves Jesus, who loves the truth, should boycott the lies of the Catholic Church, should protest against the Catholic Church and their lies. Here we have the leader of the Catholic Church, and they even call him Holy Father, who is without fault, who is true, and what he says is from God. Here we have the leader, the supreme leader of the Catholic Church, who should be a shepherd for his sheep, and who should keep the wolf away from the sheep, who doesn't know the gospel, who doesn't know the word of God. Because he's saying that we are all the children of God. When he say we, he talk about all religions who don't have God. This is so off. We are not all the children of God. We are all the creation of God. Yes, but we are not all the children of God. See what John is saying in John 1:12. But to all who did receive him, and that is Jesus Christ, who believe in his name, he, that is God, gave the right to become the children of God, who were born not of blood, nor on the will of the flesh, or nor of the will of man, but of God. When do we become the children of God? When we believe in the name of Jesus, when we are born again. We are born into the family of God. Jesus is our brother. God is our father. He's our father. He's not the Muslim's father. He's not the Hindu's father. He's not the Buddhist father. He's not the atheist father. He's our father. When we are born again, when we receive the Holy Spirit that is crying, Abba, Father. But here we have a guy, the Pope, a church leader, who's deceiving millions of people right now, who believe and who's saying that everyone is the children of God. He cannot, it's impossible that he is a born again believer. He cannot be a mature Christian and lead a church when he's doing something like this. But I've heard many leaders in the Protestant churches who talk about the Pope like he's the best man in the world. Many. And you don't know how bad it is right now, how many we are talking about. Many love the Pope. Kenneth Copeland himself, he said that the biggest day in his life was when he met the Pope. To you out there, stop, please stop. Stop inviting those people in. This is a deceiving spirit. Stop doing this. Yes, I know of many people who do a good job preaching the gospel, that they love the Pope, but still, it's wrong. And I understand this can be difficult for many people, because what is it not to love about the new Pope? He seems so nice. What is it not to love about it? If you don't know the truth, of course. But when you know the truth, you see how deceiving he is. And what is it Jesus saying? Jesus saying this in Luke 6:26. Woe to you when all speak well of you, for so the fathers did of the false prophet. Jesus is saying, woe to you when everyone speak good about you. They also did this with the false prophet. Here he said, another place in John 15, that the world would hate us. They hated him and the world would hate us. The first early Christianity was a martyr Christianity. They were killed. They were hated by many because of the name of Jesus Christ. But here we have a Pope who's loved by everyone. So many leaders in the Protestant churches love him. People love him. The Muslims love him. The Buddhists love him. The atheists love him. Why? Because he's deceiving everyone. It's so sad to see. I want to share this, and I want to send this warning to everyone out there. I see two movements is happening right now at the same time. There is a movement, and I'm part of that. I believe in that. And that is that we are drawing away from the system. We are drawing away from the Roman Catholic Church. The lies in the institution. We see it also in the Lutheran Church. The hierarchy, the money machine, the compromise, the false teaching. We are all drawing out of that, out of Babylon, to use that word. Back to the Word of God. Preaching the full gospel without compromise. Preaching salvation in Jesus alone. And that you need to be born again. That we need to turn away from our sins and then get baptized with full immersion and receive the Holy Spirit. A priesthood of all believers, where every born again believer can hear from God. And everyone have the access to God through Jesus Christ and Him alone. That is a movement that is happening right now. But I see another movement that is even bigger. And that is the movement where they're going back under the institution. Back under the system. Back under the Catholic Church. The one world religion. And I want to have nothing to do with it. I don't believe in it. And I'm going to warn very clear from now on. Because this deception is so clear. Come on. I'm just saying the video the Pope did. Saying that we are all the children of God. That video alone should be enough. That every Protestant Christian out there should protest again. Against the Catholic Church. If something less than that was happening in a church by a priest, by a leader, people should address it. And him who shared this should repent or leave the church. This is heresy. This is big time heresy. But when the Pope is saying it, nobody's doing anything. And to be honest, I don't believe that many of those leaders who are already on that train, driving very, very fast in the wrong direction. I don't believe that many of them, when jump off that train, the unity train, the false unity train, one world religion train, because they are so influenced by the contacts and the friends and all the talk about unity, 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 unity. I actually did a video a few weeks ago where I explained what Jesus was really saying in John 17 about unity and how we have misunderstood it. He's not talking about a unity like this. He's talking about a unity like this between us and our Father who's in heaven. Us and Jesus who's in heaven sitting beside God's right hand. To you out there, that is not on this train yet. Protest. Say something. Preach the truth. Preach the truth. Preach the gospel without compromise. That is our weapon. Studying the Word of God. And what the true gospel is all about. And go on YouTube. And see what the Catholic Church and the Pope is really about. What they're really saying. Because he's saying one thing when he's together with the Protestant. He's saying another thing when he's together with the Muslim. And he's saying something third when he's together with other people. And if there is a conference someplace and they invite a Catholic priest in, Those priests are not there by their own name. They are there representing all of this. They are all representing the Pope and what the Roman Catholic Church believe. If they are truly born again and do not represent the Pope, they will take the priest's clothes off. And they will also draw away from the Catholic Church and go against the lies. So if you see a conference like that, don't go. Warn them. Say you don't want to be part of a conference with the Catholic Church. And then share this video. Speak the truth. We need that. And then experience the life God has for you. God is doing beautiful things. He's calling people out for the system. No matter if you are in the Catholic Church or Lutheran Church or another place. He's calling people out right now. And there's an amazing life out here. Led by the Holy Spirit. Going around and proclaiming the word. Preaching the truth. Seeing life change. People born again. Healed, set free from demons. Hope you got something out of this warning. Hope it's going to challenge many people and make people wake up. God bless you.